Welcome to Learn Stroke. This is IAS Radio and you are listening to Daily News Leads. So now let's quickly discuss the important articles from today's Hindu. The first one, Chellanam project to begin soon. 344 crore project to protect Chellanam coast from sea erosion. This article is about the Chellanam coast in Kerala, which has been suffering due to sea erosion for a long time. In addition to all that has been given in the article, I would like to grab your attention to an important concept given here, that is the geotextile bags. Take note of the concept, geotextile bags with sand, granite boulders and tetrapods will be used for coastal protection. In your geography GS1, you have something called as important geophysical phenomena. In that you have cyclones, hurricanes, earthquakes, all such geophysical phenomena. So when you learn all such things, keep a track of the recent measures that are adopted to prevent such geophysical phenomena. In that regard, geotextile bags are important. Talking about the editorial, the virtue of consistency. India's focus must be on vaccinating a large number every day and not record highs. So this is about the COVID vaccination drive that is happening across India. Apart from the facts and figures given, take note of this important point. During the pandemic, the focus should not be on setting records, but on consistently vaccinating a large number of people daily and ensuring that vaccines are available at all centers every day. Uncertainty in vaccine availability does not help in increasing uptake, especially among the poor. So you can note such facts when you write essay for welfare schemes for the vulnerable sections. America's Asia policy. The US must push for a rules-based international order despite Afghan debacle. President Joe Biden has found himself in the uncomfortable position of facing not only the expected criticism from Republicans for his country's hasty, botched exit from Afghanistan, but also brickbats from within the Democratic Party and among the broader American public. So this is regarding America's stand on the Afghanistan issue. So every day you have numerous articles regarding the Afghanistan issue. So whenever you read such articles, understand what every country has to say about it. This article is specifically regarding America's perspective. Yesterday on, we had articles on India's perspective. So read all such articles, have a 360 coverage of articles relating to the Afghanistan issue and develop a perspective of your own. It will definitely help you for your mains and for your interview as well. A monetization move that doesn't tick most boxes. The national monetization pipeline may not help realize the best value for public assets to kickstart investment demand. So just go through the article and I would like to seek your attention regarding the important concepts in economy mentioned in this article. I'll mention a few concepts. Make sure that you prepare notes on each and every concept that I mentioned, because definitely one of these is going to pop up in your prelims paper. Disinvestment and privatization. Try to understand what these individually are. Disinvestment and privatization. Tax GDP ratio. Asset monetization. I have already mentioned public-private partnership. Next is assets purchase program known as quantitative easing. Then concepts related to GDP. Various concepts related to the gross domestic product are very important. It will definitely find a place in your question papers and it's very, very confusing if you are not clear with it. Next is foreign institutional investors, the difference between FII, foreign institutional investors, and FDI, foreign direct investment, is very, very important. Crowding out of private investment, yet another concept. the Consumer Price Index, CPI combined, the Consumer Price Index and Wholesale Price Index is very important. Next is public debt to GDP ratio. So take note of all the concepts and make notes and make sure that you have clarity regarding the concepts. Don't just mug up, but have clarity regarding each and every economic concept. Next, there is a mention that debt monetization seems a better option than asset monetization. Once again, debt monetization seems a better option than asset monetization. Such statements can be asked for your mains paper, either in your GS or in your essay paper. India is indeed walking the green talk. Even with all its challenges, the country is setting a global example in meeting its nationally determined contributions. So something related to the 5th anniversary of the Paris Agreement on climate change, you have a mention regarding G20 nations. So try to find out which are the G20 nations. Next is the Climate Change Performance Index, very important. Try to find out what the Climate Change Performance Index is all about and who releases it and such facts. Then Global Greenhouse Gases or GHGs, very important. Then something is mentioned about the Unnat Jyoti by Affordable LEDs for All, Ujala scheme, which is the world's largest zero subsidy LED bulb program for domestic consumers. Government schemes are extremely important both for your prelims and mains, especially for your prelims. When similar schemes are asked for the exam, you often tend to get confused. So make sure that you have clarity regarding various government schemes, especially the recently launched ones. Next, there is a mention regarding the COP26 or the Conference of Parties. Learn more about it. The Kyoto Protocol, something very important. The nationally determined contributions committed in the Paris Agreement, the NDCs. Definitely, you should make a note on what the NDC is all about. Then something about China and US. China, the world's largest GHG emitter, joined the Race to Zero and targets carbon neutrality by 2060. Interestingly, it hopes to peak CO2 emissions by 2030 for bending the emissions curve. So when such statements are given for your prelims exam, you often tend to mark it as wrong. That is, it hopes to peak CO2 emissions by 2030. But when you find such facts in newspaper, take note of that and keep revising it. As part of mitigation efforts, India is implementing various measures for the climate change mitigation. So take note of all such facts. Many facts are being mentioned, various government schemes, government initiatives. So take note of all that. Then there's a mention about the Coalition for Disaster Resilient Infrastructure, a partnership of governments, United Nations agencies, multilateral development banks, the private sector and knowledge institutions. The next two articles are very good for a general reading, and some of the random facts mentioned, if you can remember it well and good, use it for your essay paper. The first one, marital rape and indignity to women. The marital rape exception is antithetical to women's dignity, equality and autonomy. The next one, still hanging fire on transparency, courts need to go beyond appealing to the fictional conscience of our lawmakers. This is regarding a recent judgment by Supreme Court. That is, a Supreme Court bench headed by Justice Rohinton F. Nariman fined 8 political parties for being in contempt of the court's directions to inform citizens about the criminal antecedents of their candidates. So the concept that you need to understand here is regarding the contempt of court, and try to read more about the constitutional provisions which try to curb the criminal antecedents of the electoral candidates. The vaccine's last mile problem, that is regarding the vaccine delivery mechanism. Just have a general reading, try to understand what is being mentioned. And there is an organization that is mentioned here, that is UNOPS, the UN's Infrastructure and Procurement Agency. This organization is very relevant at times when globally vaccines are distributed. Next, the data point is also regarding the vaccine supply, that is disproportionate vaccine supply. In all states where the supply has remained low, the vaccination pace has remained poor too. In 10 states, less than 50% of the adult population has been vaccinated with at least one dose. So this is regarding the disparities in vaccine distribution in India, the share of potential doses, the state-wise utilization and cases of vaccine wastage and case burden and supply. So try to read through and note down the important facts. Marandi issue hangs fire in Jharkhand. No decision yet on anti-defection law. Though this is a political article relating to an issue in Jharkhand, anti-defection law has been mentioned here, and anti-defection law is extremely important for your UPSC exam. So try to learn all the constitutional provisions relating to anti-defection law. This is renovation, not restoration. Historians say the new look Jallianwala Bagh is a distortion of history. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi had dedicated to the nation on August 28th the renovated Jallianwala Bagh. So Jallianwala Bagh incident is very important for your UPSC exam this year. India can deal with changing Afghan situation. Rajnath, events raising new questions for national security, he says. Though this article finds a mention about the Afghanistan issue, this is a very relevant article from the internal security perspective, and internal security is specifically mentioned in your syllabus, issues related to internal security. So read the article thoroughly. India supports Palestine peace process. Shringla, Afghanistan situation dominates UN Security Council proceedings as India's presidency draws to a close. So something about India's efforts to reinstate the peace process in Israel-Palestine issue. Israel-Palestine issue, for those who don't know the history and the recent status, Israel-Palestine issue is a very important issue from the international relations perspective. Definitely, you need to give a serious reading about it. Can't curtail right to move freely or reside anywhere on flimsy grounds. This is regarding the externment orders. The concept of externment orders has been mentioned here. For those who don't know, try to find out what externment orders is. 102 Vande Bharat trains to be operational by 2024. Railways to source components only from Indian suppliers. This is regarding the Vande Bharat Express trains, and these are semi-high-speed trains that can attain an operational efficiency of 160 km per hour. So this was earlier called as Train 18. The article mentions about it, and try to understand more about the features of Vande Bharat trains. Ire over toy train monetization plan. Private companies' focus will be on profit. Local aspirations will be ignored. So this is regarding the protest in Darjeeling Hills of West Bengal against the center's proposed monetization of the Darjeeling Himalayan Railways, or the DHR. The article mentions about the four fully functional and operational railway networks in mountainous and hilly terrains in India. So take note of all the four railway networks. And there is a mention about the DHR, that is built in the British era between 1879 and 1881. The Darjeeling Toy Train was declared a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1999. So UNESCO's World Heritage Sites are extremely important. Never ever ignore the recent developments regarding the World Heritage Sites. New initiative in Jammu and Kashmir to restore lost glory of Pashmina shawls. Plans are effort to re-engage women artisans in critical production process by doubling wages and announcing MSPs for GI certified products. GI certification is also very important. The GI tag, or the geographical indication tag. Pashmina's shawl is one such product that has got the GI identification. So recent developments regarding geographical indications and new products added to the list are very important. North Korea may have restarted N-reactor IAEA, deeply troubling development, a sign it's expanding banned weapons program, says UN agency. So in this article, IAEA, the International Atomic Energy Agency, is important. Then the mention about the Yongbyon reactor in North Korea. Track what is happening in North Korea with respect to this reactor. And in from the geography perspective, in the map, try to locate North Korea and its neighboring countries. Leaded petrol eradicated, says UNEP. The United Nations Environmental Programme, or UNEP, has said that nearly a century after doctors first issued warning about the toxic effects of leaded petrol, Algeria, the last country to use the fuel, exhausted its supplies last month. So, read more about the concept of leaded petrol. And in the map, try to locate Algeria and its neighboring countries. Thanks for listening. This is IAS Radio.